So, what did we find? The linear integrating fire neuron with exclusively excitatory drive produces very clock-like behavior. Why is that happening? Well, we always start at zero. It only goes up. And after a certain period of time, I will have accumulated enough current to be spiking again. Every time we spike, there's this red line here. But the fact that it's very predictable in a way is a violation of what we were looking for. What we have is we have neurons that have exponential interspike intervals, or at least in good approximation, but the output of those neurons doesn't look exponential at all. It looks like a small Gaussian within a very narrow range. So there's something wrong about our model. And now wearing my hat, I can say, well, look, my model must be wrong. A network that is primarily excitatory becomes very regular, and that is exactly not what we see when we look at actual physiology. But then we can go back to what we know about biology and say, well, we know there's excitation, but there's also inhibition. What if the two of them were of the same strength? Now it is time for you to implement that model. What we have is now the voltage change is the current as we had it before, but there's a second term which makes it decay towards zero. That is this first, that's this term here. This is the decay. That's why it's called a leaky integrating fire neuron, what you'll be building here. The second one is we will have balanced excitation and inhibition. So now the current is not just positive, but there's going to be a random number of spikes coming in from excitatory neurons, which produce positive current, and a random number of spikes that are inhibitory that make the membrane potential go down, or that is a negative current, and that's why things look like this. Now it is time for you to implement it. Just like before, we set up the infrastructure around it, and your goal is just to implement how the voltage changes over time.